Hey guys, welcome back to My Preloved Affair. If you are new here, my name is Meg, and if you are a returning viewer or subscriber, then thanks. If you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and click that subscribe button. You can also hit the notification bell right next to it so that you know when I upload videos. And today we're gonna talk about mistakes I've made in pre-loved shopping. Okay, so I have transitioned from being a brand new shopaholic to a pre-loved shopaholic. It's not funny, honestly. So yes, I wanted to talk about the mistakes that I have made, and in the hopes that you wouldn't make the same mistakes that I did. In the previous video, I had talked about like an update on my shopping addiction and what I've been doing to keep myself on track. And now I'm going to talk to you guys about some of the things that I did in the past that I don't do anymore. Okay. Number one, buying because it's on sale. Okay. So probably one of the biggest things about my shopping addiction before was that I always looked out for sales or for coupon codes for things that, or sometimes even if I don't look for it, it just pops onto my social media because that's what algorithm does. Once you when they say that your phone is always listening to you, that's true. Like I mentioned something, you even just have to think about it and something is going to come up, because you know, artificial intelligence, they learn things and they know what to hook you with. Anyways, so mistakes that I've made in the past, even before transitioning into pre-loved, was that I would buy something just because it was on sale, even though I've never even thought that I needed that item or that I wanted it to begin with. When I see something that's on sale, I even had this habit of, if I have some time to spare, I'll walk into the shops, just have a browse, go into the sale rack, see what's there, and then come home with two bags full of clothes that I never needed, right? Why? Because it was on sale. Now I begin to question myself and ask, well, if it wasn't on sale, would I be interested in it? Is this something that I really wanted before that I was even willing to pay full price for it? Because if it's not, then it's not probably something that I actually want on in my wardrobe. It's probably not something that I would wear, right? That I'm just interested in it because it's on sale. Something that I have to keep reminding myself is that you're not actually saving on a sale item if you never needed it to begin with. Right? You would have saved 100% if you never bought it, as opposed to the 25-50%. Okay. And oftentimes things that go on sale because no one wants to buy them. Either they're not that great or they've overproduced it. In which case, then we need to keep not buying them so that the manufacturers realize that you shouldn't be overproducing these things because it's not gonna sell, right? And when they start losing money because they've overproduced, maybe they'll start scaling down their production instead of filling landfills with textile waste. Okay. Well, that's one of the reasons why I've started going the pre-loved route. Like I would go to markets, flea markets, like the Caribbean markets here, Roselle markets, the fancy flea market, where I found my beautiful Chloe bag for $50, and it's real, right? So, I've started going the pre-loved route, but when I did that and realized just how much cheaper I could get real good quality clothing, I started stocking up on clothing. To a point where I even had to start another Instagram account so that I could sell the clothing. And at one point I would go into op shops and buy stuff thinking that I would wear them and then I wouldn't, and then I would have to sell them. Or honestly, there was you don't see it, but here on this side, next to the wall, there used to be a box full of clothes that I bought from the op shops that turned out didn't look good on me. Or I thought that I would be wearing them, but it just sat there in the closet because it was not my style at all. Like, I see all of this like vintage clothing and I'm like, I'm gonna rock that. No, I'm not. I'm not. I'm a t-shirt, jeans kind of girl. I'm not, you know, on the rare occasions that I would wear a dress, there are a handful of dresses that I actually like to wear. Right? And I will stick to those dresses because they're comfortable, because they fit well, because they look good on me. There's no need for me to buy any more. But really, at the beginning of my secondhand journey, I accumulated so much. I bought so much because it's so cheap. I can afford to buy multiples of it, you know? And like, our spare room kind of ended up being like an extension of my closet, full of things that I don't wear, right? Now, why did I go into the secondhand route? Because, well, there's a lot of really still great clothing out there that has still got a lot of life in it, but it's getting thrown away, right? So my reasoning was like, you know, environment, but really it's my own greed, because when I discovered that I could get, I think, what was it? It was a pair of Levi's jeans for $8 and then a pair of Diesel jeans for $5. I at one point had almost 20 pairs of jeans and I only had two legs. And I barely wear jeans anyway, you know, so because I'm just at home. Anyway, so yeah, that's like the second mistake. Well, first one is that I buy on sale, even though I don't need it. The second one is that when I started going pre-loved, I bought a lot. Okay. The third one is that, especially when I discovered buying pre-loved designer bags, I wanted bags in every color. I had a mint green Marc Jacobs. I had a cobalt blue Kate Spade. I had a mustard yellow Tory Burch. And pretty much everything in between. I think the only color of bag that I didn't buy was pink, because I'm not a pink person. I even bought a Chanel purple. Well, it's not purple, it's aubergine bag, which I've sold off. Right? All of the bags that I've just mentioned are no longer with me. I've sold them. Why? Because I don't wear them. They're not colors that I normally typically wear. They are not colors that match any of my outfits. Although, honestly, my outfits are much more neutral, so I could really just use them as a pop of color, but honestly, it just wasn't for me. Right? Yeah, I wanted them in every color, so I bought them and I've sold them, some for profit, some for not. I basically broke even. But that was like one of the reasons why I had at one point about 27 bags, right? Mistake number four. When I discovered luxury secondhand shopping, I wanted a bag in every brand. Like, I would look out, I would go and do a search for Fendi, Dior, Bottega Veneta, Prada, Louis Vuitton, Chanel, Saint Laurent, Balenciaga, Loewe. Like, I wanted everything. I wanted one from every brand. I bought a Louis Vuitton Siracusa MM, sold. I bought that Chanel Aubergine, sold. I bought my Christian Dior mini Boston bag in patent leather, I knew I wasn't going to love patent leather, and I knew it was going to be fuzzy, but I still bought it because it's Christian Dior. Where is that? It's up on eBay for sale. I bought a Saint Laurent camera bag. I knew I didn't like the tassel, but I could remove the tassel, so that was fine. But I had so many bags that it went on the chopping block, so that's also on eBay at the moment. I bought a Coach Field Tote 30 that's up for sale as well, because I don't use it. I'm not a tote person. I don't know why I bought a tote. I'm not a tote person. I have one tote here, which is my Chanel surf tote. That's it. I bought, what else did I buy? I had a Fendi Celeria messenger bag that I've sold on. I had a Christian Dior saddlebag, the Gaucho one, that I've sold. And it was only after all of these buying and reselling and making money, losing money, that I realized that, you know, you don't have to have a bag from every brand. You only need a bag that you actually love, regardless of what brand it is. Example. The Ava 25 from Handbag Crave. It's not even a designer, right? But I love the bag. Spent $260, I think, on this beautiful Kelly lookalike. Love the bag. There's some issues with it in the sense that there's some annoyances and nuances on the bag, especially when it comes to like opening and closing it, but not enough for me to let it go, right? So it doesn't matter what brand of bag you have, as long as you love it, as long as you're going to use it. Because the worst thing is to have a bag like my Chanel Classic flap that I don't want to use. So yeah, that's like my fourth mistake. It's not about the brands. It's about whether you love it and whether you're going to use it, right? And the last mistake I've had or I've made since going pre-loved is being much more focused on the price point than the quality of the bag. Because I have had some experiences where I bought the bag for, I was like, oh yeah, what a steal. And then the bag arrives and it's like, it's not the quality that I want. It's not the quality that I would be proud to carry. Like for example, that Louis Vuitton Syracuse bag that I have, that had color transfer, and it's demi azure, so it's really a light color. It had color transfer on the front and on the back from jeans. Inside were pen marks, lipstick marks. Bought it for $600 because it's Louis Vuitton. And a $600 Louis Vuitton is a cheap Louis Vuitton. But you know what? I could have bought a brand new Coach bag for that amount and not have to be embarrassed about the color transfer or the pen marks in the bag. Right? So get something that you're going to use and that you're going to love. Not just because you want to impress people or you want people to see that you're carrying a luxury designer bag, because who cares? Honestly, who cares? Right. Yeah, so those are all the mistakes I can think of. There's probably more. If there's more that I think of afterwards, I am going to make a part two of this video. But anyway, I want to actually tag a few friends to do this video as well, to talk about their shopping mistakes. Not necessarily pre-loved, but it could be like if you're somebody who loves to buy new, right? So I'd like to tag Kenny, and I'd like to tag Ron. Kenny from Kenny Ford Alessa and Ron from Ramiro Fi. I would love to see your videos about the mistakes you've made with shopping and the lessons you've learned. Right, that's all for me today. I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.